This is part two of solving equations containing radical expressions, and we use the power rule. That's where you can square both sides, or cube both sides, or raise both sides to any power, and the solutions of the original equation will be amongst the solutions of the new equation, but it does not go the other way around. You might get some solutions in your new equation that do not check in the original. So the warning is, make sure you check all your solutions in the original equation. In part one, we came up with a process to make it easier to solve a radical equation. First, we isolate one radical on one side of the equation. The reason I say one radical is a problem might contain two radicals, so you might just have to do one at a time. And then we'll raise each side to some power to get rid of the square root, cube root, etc. But if there's another radical, we'll repeat steps one and two. We'll isolate the next radical until we could finally solve the equation. And number four is extremely important. You want to check all solutions. All right, here's a problem. Square root of 2x minus 3 plus 3 equals 6. So step one is to isolate the square root. So we want to keep the square root of 2x minus 3 over here, let's say, so we'll subtract 3 from both sides. And then we are isolating the 2x minus 3 under the radical sign on one side of the equation. Right now we could square both sides. And remember, when you square a square root, you get what's underneath the radical. It undoes it. So we have 2x minus 3 equals 9. So now we have an equation, a linear equation, because there's no x squared term, there's no square root term, etc. So we're just going to solve for x by getting the constants on one side, variables on the other. So we could add 3 to both sides, divide by 2, and we get 6. Now we have to make sure this checks. So let's check this into the original. So here's the original equation. We're going to check to see if 6 is really a solution. So we're going to put in 6 for x and simplify the left-hand side first. So to simplify this square root, I have to simplify inside the square root. So I've got to do 2 times 6, which is 12, and minus 3 is 9. So this gives me a square root of 9 plus 3. The square root of 9 is 3, so I have 3 plus 3. And 3 plus 3 adds up to 6. And I see I have 6 on the other side, so it checks. So that means our solution really is 6. So the correct solution to the problem was 6. All right, we're going to look at this problem again. I'm going to show you a common mistake so that you don't make it. Remember, we got the solution of 6 and we checked it, so we know the answer really is going to be x equals 6. Just keep that in mind. Now, a common mistake is not to isolate the radical. And people simply just put that they're going to square both sides like this, and they think that when you square this binomial, they get to just square this square root, which will give you the 2x minus 3, and then they square the 3, which is 9, and then they square the 6, which is 36. Unfortunately, that's not true. The left-hand side is incorrect, because if you were going to square this binomial, you're going to have a big middle term. It gets to be pretty messy. So let's say you made this mistake. Let's just keep going. 2x plus 6 equals 36. I'm going to keep mistake so you remember this really isn't true. That over there is a mistake to write that like that. And then if we subtract 6 from both sides, we get 2x equals 30. And x will be 15. Now remember, we already did this problem. We know the answer is 6, right? But if you did it incorrectly like this, if you made this mistake, if you check your answer, you see it's not going to check. So when we check it, we take the original problem, and we're going to put in 15 for x. See, 2 times 15 minus 3 is underneath the radical. So that's the square root of 33. I'm sorry. 30 minus 3, square root of 27, plus 3. Now, the square root of 27 actually simplifies to 3 square roots of 3, but that you're not going to be able to combine these terms. So the square root of 27 plus 3 is never going to equal 6. That's really the main point here. So you could finish and write this as 3 square roots of 3. Remember, because 27 is 9 times 3. So that's why the 3 would come out. But these are unlike terms. So 3 square roots of 3 plus 3 is not equal to 6. This does not check. And that's how you know that that is the incorrect answer. But to get the correct answer, you would have to redo the problem and isolate the square root like we did it the first time I did the problem. All right, here's another problem. I have two square roots in the problem, and actually, they're both isolated, but you just have to make sure one's isolated. And so we can go ahead and just square both sides. Now, another way of thinking about this, you've got the square root of something equaling the square root of something else. Hopefully it makes sense to you that whatever's under the square root really has to be the same thing, which is what you'll get on your next step when you square both sides. You'll get that what's underneath the square root on this side, on the left side, actually equals what's underneath the square root on the right side. So now we can solve this. Let's subtract 2x from both sides. And we'll add 9 to both sides to get 3x is 6. Dividing by 3, we get x equals 2. And then we want to make sure it checks. So let's check in the original. So square root of 5x minus 9, square root of 2x minus 3. And we're going to plug in 2 for x. So I've got square root of 5 times 2 minus 9. And what's that? All right, underneath the radical, that's 10 minus 9. So I end up with a square root of 1, which is 1, right? And over on the other side, I've got 2 times 2 minus 3. I'm going to have 4 minus 3 under the radical, square root of 1. And both do simplify to 1, the same number. So that means that 2 was the correct solution. So 2 was the correct solution to that one. All right, let's do this one. We've got two radicals, right? And I want to isolate one of the radicals. And notice the square root of 5, the square root of x plus 5 on the left is isolated. That's all we have on the left side. So we can go ahead and square both sides. At least we'll get rid of that radical. But on the right-hand side, this is a binomial. We'll have to be careful when we square a binomial. So on the left-hand side, when I square a square root, I get what's left underneath the square root, which is x plus 5. And now on the right-hand side, if you need to write it out, you could think of this as square root of x plus 1 times square root of x plus 1. Okay, and you could do the FOIL method. So the first term will be square root of x times square root of x, which is x. And the outer term will be square root of x, and the inner term will be square root of x. You're going to get a 2 square roots of x when you do the outer and the inner term, plus the last term, 1 squared. All right. Now, since there's still a square root, we need to isolate that square root. All right, so what we want to do is subtract x and subtract 1 from both sides. All right, so we're going to subtract x and we're going to subtract 1 from both sides of the equation. And I have 4 equals 2 square roots of x. Well, we can divide by 2 because that's a coefficient to make it 2 equals square root of x. And now I have the square root of x isolated, so now I could square this. So 4 equals x. All right, so it looks like x is 4. And of course, we want to make sure that's the correct solution, so we're going to check our answer. All right, so let's see if 4 is the solution here. So we're going to plug in 4 for x. And on the left-hand side, we have to simplify underneath the radical. Square root of 9 is 3. And on the right-hand side, we're going to plug in 4. Square root of 4 is 2. So I have 2 plus 1, which is 3. So yes, 4 is the solution to this problem. Okay?